The project, which is funded by the World Bank, was launched by Sarah Mateke Nyirabashishi, the State Minister for Youth and Children Affairs, at Igongo Country Hotel in Imbarara City. Launching the 818 billion shillings project, dubbed Generation Grow Opportunities and Productivity for Women Entrepreneurs, on Friday, the minister requested the district leaders to generate a list of women entrepreneurs who are eligible for the project if the project is to have impact. Minister Nyirabashishi said the new project is different from other funds that were launched by the government, as this one targets women who are already in business.
While these other programs were looking at the women coming to groups to give them the money, this is different. You can ask as an individual to boost your business. For example, we want the women. We have women who have been in wine making. We have women who are making tea, who are adding value to different products, but have not had an opportunity for UNBS to clear them.
Mateke warned district officials against misusing funds and appealed to them to ensure they reach the intended beneficiaries.
I don't believe that this money is going to pass through the hands of others. It is going directly to the beneficiary. Of course, some people want to tend to beat the system, but our system is very clear.
Rosemary Nyaki Kongoro, the Shema District Woman Member of Parliament, said some women have failed to make progress in business because of exorbitant interest that is charged on bank loans and lack of collateral security.
We have seen many women in businesses, but their businesses are corrupting. They go to banks, they don't have collaterals, they don't own land, they don't own, you know, cars, they don't own those where they require collaterals. So this grant is going to boost their businesses.
The launch was attended by leaders from the districts of Ankole and Kigezi sub-regions. Report by Adolf Ayoreka for the news.